What's going on, gamers? Today, we are going to go over how to combine resource packs in Minecraft. Before we get started, don't forget to like, subscribe, and click that notification bell to stay up to date on all future videos. Customizing the way Java or Bedrock Minecraft appears in-game is a popular activity among players, and you do that by changing the textures. These are stored in resource packs, large documents containing blocks, items, sounds, particle effects, and more. If you can't find a pack that includes everything you want, you can combine them to get the look you're going for, but it usually isn't the easiest thing to do. Today we're going to go over an easier method that will have you playing in no time. Before tweaking the resource pack files, you'll want to understand some basic information about them. The first is to keep in mind that players can prioritize multiple packs in-game as a way to combine them, but this isn't perfect because certain game aspects can sometimes not be overridden. For instance, if you're wanting to have specific blocks from one resource to another, then using the default method tends to fail. Due to this issue, there are alternatives to get everything into a single file that resolves the situation. These include an automatic and a manual method, with both accomplishing the same task. It's done by prioritizing the main resource pack and then replacing some of its contents with other textures. As for finding resource packs to use, we will have one linked down below. By far the easiest way to combine resource packs is to use an online service that does it for you. This allows both Java and Bedrock players to merge textures with other customizable options available. Head to Nera's Pack Combiner website and in the top left corner, press Upload Packs and then select your desired ones. Once you're finished, drag and rearrange them according to their priority, and after that, you can enter the new resource pack's name to the right-hand side. Select the Minecraft version, and then you can choose to pick a custom icon for the new pack. After that, you can click Download Pack. Bedrock users will need to change the version and min engine version values to 1.13.0 or higher in the manifest JSON file. This can be done by opening the downloaded zip document and then editing it accordingly. Once this is done, rename the file type to mcpack from zip for compatibility, and if that doesn't work, you'll have to use the manual method instead. Now, before we go over the manual method, you're going to want to go over the differences in Java and Bedrock files. Due to the different designs, their main directory containing the resource files are going to be different. Inside Java resource packs, there will be an assets folder when you first open the document. This contains everything, but most files are going to be stored in the Minecraft textures pathway. From here, you can manage the blocks, items, entity, and other resources. Another area to make note of is the Minecraft models directory, containing JSON files of the textures. Some packs might not include all of these, as it varies for each type of resource pack. Similarly, Bedrock resource packs have a main folder called Textures containing everything. This area holds blocks, items, models, and entity directories. Sometimes other folders are stored outside the main pathway due to their design, though. These resource directories are important for the mcpack file, so make sure to keep track of any of your changes. Sometimes players might want to manually sort through specific textures to make the ideal resource pack. This process is tedious since you're required to delete and replace files or directories until you're satisfied with the result. We recommend using a zipping software like 7-Zip to access your resource pack files. Close down Minecraft and find your desired resource packs. Once found, you can open them and look through the directories until you find files to replace, and then you can delete and replace the old ones with the new variants of them. Do this for any other directories or files in the resource pack, and when you're finished, close the window and try it in-game. After merging your resource packs into a single file, you're going to be ready to use it in-game. We're going to go over how to set it up on your client, but if you're looking for how to add them to your server, you can follow our guide that will be linked down below. Launch Minecraft and head towards the options area from the main menu, and from here, press the resource packs button to see active and available textures. Near the bottom left corner, click on Open Pack Folder to reveal the file location, and then you can drag and drop your combined resource pack into this directory. This will automatically update your list in-game, which then you can activate. The Bedrock version of Minecraft has two ways to install the combined resource pack. The first is simply double-clicking the MC pack file to automatically implement it in the game. This is the preferred method, but an alternative one is to manually drag the document into a specific directory. Close down Minecraft Bedrock Edition and press the Windows key and R to open the Run window. Enter app data into the text box and press OK in the bottom left. And in the new window, you're going to use the pathway Local, Packages, Microsoft Minecraft, Local State, Games, com.mojang, and then Resource Packs. Once you're there, you can drag and drop the combined resource pack into the folder, but remember the file type has to be changed from zip to MC pack for this to work. Launch Minecraft Bedrock Edition and head towards the Settings option in the menu. And on the left-hand side, scroll down and click the Global Resources button. Find your combined textures in the My Pack section and select it, and then just press Activate for the game to automatically load everything. In cases where the resource pack isn't loading on Bedrock, make sure you've successfully changed the version values in the manifest.json file to 1.13.0 or higher. Additionally, make sure you've renamed the file type to mcpack from zip, since these are the only files supported on Minecraft Bedrock. If you've successfully loaded the combined resource pack on Minecraft, but there are problems with the textures, then this could be corruption. Most of the time, this can be resolved by playing around with the priorities in the automatic method. But if you're using the manual way instead, you will have to revert your changes and carefully redo them to test what is the cause of the broken textures. As you can see, combining resource packs isn't the easiest thing to do, but it does pay off in the end when you get the exact look that you want in your game. Of course, if you can, you should try to use the automatic option, but now that you know how to use both, you'll be playing with your new textures in no time.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more great content like this, then subscribe or click these videos. Until next time, gamers.